Hello, I'm Donna.
I'm Sarah.
This is Kelsey.
Hi.
And we have got an unforgettable episode of Less Code, More Power today because we have cookies. And if you want to know more about those cookies, you need to tune in.
Yes.
See ya. Hello. We are back with Less Code, More Power. I'm Donna.
I'm Sarah.
And today we have probably our most favorite guest in the whole world, Kelsey Bloomquist, because she brought us a very special gift. She brought cookies for a power platform.
Look at this.
Look at that. How cute are these? How cute are these? And she even brought us Less Code, More Power cookies. She not only brought us these lovely display pieces, but she brought individual ones for us. How lucky are we?
Yeah.
Thank you so much.
I'm so happy to be here today. I'm just so excited. I've always wanted to do something like this and showcase my wonderful Power Platform cookies that I'm totally geeking out creating.
So tell us about you. Tell us everything about you. How did you end up in Power Platform? What do you work on right now?
Sure. Well, I actually started at Microsoft right out of college,
and
I went to the CRM team as a developer.
Okay.
And you know, 2 years ago we merged with Power Apps, and then we sort of expanded in Power BI and Power Automate, and I started using those applications as well, and I loved them all. And I was sort of like, how can I use all of these applications, right?
Amazing.
So I started venturing out and looking, and I found this new position on the ISV engagement team under Steven Guggenheimer.
Ah, tell us what ISV is.
Yeah.
ISV is an independent solution vendor.
Okay.
So there are partners who build solutions on top of our platform, and then they sell them out to their own customers.
Cool.
Right, so we're sort of here to help them technically and in business so that they can be successful in their application creations.
I love it. So you are helping all these devs be super successful so they can go and help millions of companies.
Yes, exactly.
So powerful.
We help each other. It's mutual benefits.
I love it. So that's what you work on. And what does your day-to-day look like?
My day-to-day? Well, I have a lot of hobbies.
Yes.
Like, I love Power Platform, I love work, but I also have a lot of things I enjoy outside of work.
Love it.
Whether that's traveling or
that's cool.
Music and art or even sports. You know, I do snowboarding in the winter and biking in the summer. But I also really love to bake.
I see. Yes.
We're appreciative of that.
We like this hobby. If all of you who want to also are bakers want to come on the show, that's cool too.
Yep.
We'll find a spot for you.
Yeah. So over Thanksgiving break, I had a little downtime since I was here, and we had just finished touring the world after we had our ISV Connect program launch.
Mm-hmm.
And so we're teaching our partner ecosystem about the new platform and Power Apps and CDS and how they all fit together and why we've made these platform changes so that it's easier for them to build and create their solutions. And as a part of this, I was doing presentations, and there kept coming up this slide that would make me smile every time because it had all four logos of our Power Platform.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
And I love the colors and I just loved the symmetry and it was something I loved.
Yes.
And I wanted to bring those logos into my personal life somehow.
I love that.
And I didn't want to just, you know, have the laptop stickers that everyone else has, although I love those. I wanted to do something different. So I was in the mood to bake. I had a lot of time to make cookies, and I decided to make Power Platform cookies.
Mm-hmm. This is so cool. Like, I just love I've never seen this before, but I just love how much energy you've got around just what you do. Like, the fact that, you know, you truly believe in, like, spreading the message to partners from the ISV perspective, because the platform is huge, and there's a lot of opportunity out there for partners as well.
Right.
But you've actually taken this into your personal life.
Mm-hmm.
That's in such a delicious way.
Yeah.
Like, oh, thank you.
Exactly.
Yes, and they're all different flavors. So it's just amazing.
The attention to detail that you have is amazing.
It's amazing.
Yeah.
Because the detailed stenciling on these is off the hook. It's absolutely wild.
So it's awesome you bring that up. So the original cookies I made are sort of these layered cookies where I've baked separate pieces and frosted them, and then I've pieced them together after the fact.
Amazing.
And they use royal icing, so it stays wet, but then once I place them, it'll harden really solid and have that nice smooth look. And so, you know, I've featured all four of the Power Platform applications here.
Love it.
But the second round, because you guys asked me to come on here, I wanted to do something, you know, a different variation, something even more exciting.
Extra.
And, you know, that slide that I bring up, they all show in circles and they have the logos in the center.
Yes.
So I was like, hey, circles are really easy to make. Why can't I just, you know, get a logo on there?
Yep.
But piping that logo would be so difficult over and over and over again. So I decided to create a stencil. for which I actually bought a die cutting machine.
That stencils.
Is amazing.
And I made these power platform stencils. So I've got one for each logo.
Wow.
It's probably kind of difficult to see because they're clear. But then I also created one for that less code, more power in order to showcase your show
that.
Here
that
today
is cool.
And the launch.
That is
so cool.
This is that stencil.
There's so there's a little stencil. Laptop that we're coding on right now in our less code, more power.
That is so cool.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Talk about creativity, and you've got such an interesting eye for how to showcase things in a very different, cool, creative, interesting sort of way. That's wonderful.
Well, thank you. Yeah, I love to bring creativity in both my personal and my work life. Mm-hmm. And what's awesome is this was able to help me bridge that gap baking and work. And when I made these stencils, you know, it's amazing because they're reusable. I can use them on anything. I can use them on baking, but now I can also use them in other projects.
That's right.
And what's great about reusable components is that we actually feature something like that within our application, within our Power app.
Reusable components, tell us.
Yes. Yeah. So, as I mentioned, I was a developer for 7 years in CRM previously, and I was on the Power Apps component framework team.
Okay. Wow, I'm seeing this story. This
I love this. This is some storytelling right here.
This is unfolding.
What you're watching is master storytelling. Yeah. Go on, tell us
more.
And
so you ask, what's PCF, right? Now, this is one unified framework that brings together our model-driven apps and our Canvas apps.
What does PCF stand for, so for the audience?
Power Apps Component Framework.
Power Apps Component Framework.
It's the framework that allows you to make components to embed in your Power Apps.
I see. Very cool.
Right.
Okay.
And so Microsoft makes our own components, but we also allow third-party developers to create theirs. Mm-hmm. And so they can code those up, and then they can import it into the system, into the environment, and use those controls. And what's amazing is once you create it, you can reuse them in any application.
I
so like that. The stencils, they are reusable across all applications.
Think about the time that that saves, right? So, and it's so cool because like that's very much from an ISV perspective, what you said, literally what they're doing and what partners are going to be doing, it's going to be reusable, but also from a time effort perspective for partners and customers. So like the partners can just go and build something like the stencil, go ahead and sell that out, but then also it's saving the customer's time. It's like pay it forward.
Exactly. Yeah. Huge saving in time and energy.
Love that.
Because this would have probably taken me 4 times the amount of time.
Easily.
I would have had to start weeks ago, and by now they'd be stale.
I would still be doing them now. Yeah, that's amazing. So what is your favorite part about working with ISVs? That sounds insanely fun.
My favorite part about working with ISVs is understanding their point of view and getting to know their businesses better, right? Because before, when I was a developer in Power Apps Component Framework, you know, you have work items, you're sort of in your little silo concentrating on that. But I didn't know how the application was being used with the outside world.
Right. Mm-hmm.
And now when them coming and asking questions about how do I connect here, how do I use this part of the application, I'm truly seeing how they're utilizing it and how we can make the application better for them to use, right?
That's right. Mm-hmm. You see the end-to-end.
Yeah.
From when you make the thing to how they use it to changes you make.
Right, and so I really understand the importance of that extensibility part now for our partners.
Right. And the direct customer engagement, which
is
so cool.
Oh yeah, I love directly connecting with them. I have a ball, they're all great, and I love that personal interaction, which I didn't get when I was a developer.
I love it. So ISVs out there, if you need to choose a dev to work with, choose her.
Yeah, look at that attention to detail.
Yeah, it's a lot of attention to detail.
Stuff.
I am quite detail-oriented.
I love it.
That's so cool.
We hear you've got something interesting to show us.
Yes,
I do. Mm-hmm. So while I was talking about the reusable components, I thought I would showcase some PCF components for you today.
That would be wonderful.
Yeah. And so you ask, what is PCF, right?
Yes, that's what I want to know.
Well, it's a way that our first party, Microsoft, and third party vendors can create their own components and embed them in a Power App.
Whoa.
And they are reusable and they are unified between both the model-driven and the Canvas application.
That's amazing. So just for the audience, I really want to emphasize the fact that this is something that brings the two different types of application together.
That's
this isn't just something in the Canvas app world. This isn't just something in the model-driven world.
Right.
This is something that's available across both of them.
I love that.
Awesome. So, in order to start a project, I would want to go ahead and install the Power Apps command line.
Sure.
And this is awesome because it just GA'd last year, the end of last year, but it's a way that you can spin up skeleton files for your Power App mm-hmm. so that you can understand what files you need to fill out and what lifecycle methods you'll need to, you know, put in code for mm-hmm. in order for that component to do what it needs to do within the application.
So it really helps out, right? Yeah. It helps scaffold
oh,
what
definitely.
You're trying to do.
That's right.
Yeah.
Perfect.
And so I have here a command prompt.
Yes.
And I've gone and I've installed the Power App's command prompt.
Yes.
Or command line interface.
Yes.
And so I'm going to go ahead and write PAC PCF init.
Yes.
And this is how I initialize a PCF control. And
okay.
it's telling me I'm missing arguments, right?
Yes.
Because you need to define the namespace, name, and template.
Sure.
And for time's sake,
yes.
I'm not going to go and create this. But I could yeah. go ahead and, you know, I would do pack PCF init, mm-hmm. and then I could just do the namespace,
yes.
you know, and here, oh, so what control do I want to make,
yeah.
right? So for my Power App, I'm going to create a system that allows me to track my cookie orders.
Wow.
And I'm going to call it Kelsey's Cookie Kitchen.
Oh,
this is
very cool.
Epic. This is amazing.
Because after I've created all these cookies, I've literally gotten calls for orders from everywhere.
That's going to happen today,
yeah.
too.
And I think Donna and I are going to probably be some of those big
yes.
customers.
Love it.
Yes.
Love it. So I want to go ahead and create a map control so that I can see where all of my deliveries are going to be this weekend.
I love that.
Right? So I would go ahead and define a namespace, and I would have some sort of name, whether that's like a cookie map
mm-hmm.
or something more generic because
that's
you
right.
want it to be a reusable component.
Mm-hmm.
And then I would make this a data set because it's going to be you know, multiple records, not just a single field. Right? And so that's how I would go ahead
yes.
and define it.
I
but I've
it.
Already spun up a control for you guys.
Yes.
I've created a map. Actually, the PM of PCF created it. He's awesome. He loves
Wonderful.
In his downtime to go and create these Power Apps components. He is very passionate about
this
it.
This is going to be
really
useful
exciting.
For us later. Yeah.
So I've gone ahead and imported
Whoa.
That map into my system.
How cool
and
does that
here
look?
I have a model-driven app of Kelsey's Cookie Kitchen.
Wow.
And I have all my contacts, and this is showing where all of those contacts live. Okay,
yes.
and I'm going to visit my father this weekend,
mm-hmm.
and he lives in Florida. So all of
oh.
them I'm doing this weekend
wow.
are going to be in Orlando, Florida.
Wow, that's where Kelsey's cookies are at this moment.
How cool
at this
does
moment.
That look?
Yeah,
like, that actually
that
looks
amazing.
Really
yes.
wicked.
So this is an Azure map.
Yeah.
And you know, it's a component that we've created. We've defined what to show here,
yes.
and it's using APIs to connect what
mm-hmm.
it needs to, and then it's visualizing the data set as
I
this map.
That.
And if I want to go ahead and see the grid view, I can go ahead and look at that read-only grid and see what I all have in here.
That's
so these are all my
monster.
Active contacts
yeah,
that
I
have I
love
for
it.
These orders.
Yeah.
I have Cookie Monster, Little Miss Muffin,
yes.
Peter
love
Piping
it,
Frosting, and the Sweet Tooth Fairy.
I love that.
Those are the four deliveries I have this week.
That is fantastic.
And so I'm going to go ahead and switch back to that map view.
Mm-hmm.
And so this is really helpful. I'm a very visual person.
Yes.
I want to be able to understand, okay, how much time is it going to take me to do these deliveries? And right now it's just showing them as pinpoints, but
yes.
if I wanted to go add you know, different capabilities to this app, you know, add a route or something like that, I can go and create that in the component, you know, upgrade the version, and then go import that back into the system
yeah.
and add whatever functionality I want because I own that control.
Mm-hmm. I love
right?
that. This is so freaking cool, Kelsey. I love this.
Thank
so
you.
Before we let you go, what is a call to action mm-hmm. you have for the audience, a piece of homework you'd like them to go do today?
Sure. Well, what I want you guys to do is you can go spin up your own controls, which is awesome. But if you don't really know how to get started, you can go to PCF Gallery. Really easy. PCF.gallery.
PCF Gallery.
And we have a lot of third parties who have gone and created their own custom controls for
so
you
cool.
to use. And so you can come here and you can take a look at what you need. You can look by category if you want it for a specific control. If you want it for the model app, they have the little icon there. If you want it for the Canvas app, they have a little art thing to show you what it's
wow.
available on. And you can go ahead and download that and then import it into your Power Apps environment.
PCF Snowflakes.
And so what I want you guys to do
mm-hmm.
is go to PCF.gallery, pick a control that you love,
yes.
download it, and import it into your Power Apps environment today.
I love that. That is so different and unique.
What an amazing call to action. But
mm-hmm.
I think we should go a little bit step further. And so you need to do that, but then you need to tag us in,
yes.
in a tweet when you've done that.
That's
so
right.
we know.
So we know you did it.
Yeah.
And also, I'm going to assign Sarah the homework of putting all our user groups on that map.
That is exactly. literally what we want to do.
Exactly.
Like the cool thing, and just to unpack this for a moment,
mm-hmm.
is think about the capabilities and the possibilities, both from a partner perspective and an ISV perspective, which is what you were talking about at the beginning. And the fact that you make one control, and like the stencils, right? Like these stencils, it's just you can then go ahead and keep reusing that.
I love it.
It's really cool.
Perfect.
Thank you so much.
Thank you for being
yeah.
here with us. Thank you for tuning in. And we're going to go and enjoy our delicious
yes.
Kelsey's cookies.
Yes. Via the Can't Kelsey wait to make more service. Power Platform cookies. Yes.
All right. Thank you. We'll see you soon. Less code.
More power.